Hello and welcome to this week 15 edition of Big Game Bound. I'm Chris Hagan. The playoff picture becoming more clear week by week, but still some intrigue in both the AFC and the NFC. Such is the case in our marquee matchup this week, the Lions. Yes, I said it, the Lions visiting the Jets. That's a 1 o'clock kickoff on Sunday. For more on this one, let's bring in our old pal Jack Doles on the Lions beat. Jack, can you believe this? After a 1-6 start to the season, Detroit is in the playoff discussion.
No, Chris, frankly, I can't believe it. When they were 1-6 and they traded TJ Hawkinson to the Vikings, one of our news anchors asked me jokingly about the Lions' playoff chances. And I said, that's cute. But here they are. They're playing their best football in years, probably since the Barry Sanders teams back in the early 90s. And, they win this game against the Jets this weekend, and they are definitely in the playoff picture.
Well, like a lot of people, I watched the Lions on Hard Knocks and kind of fell in love with the team, seeing some of the behind-the-scenes antics and seeing some of the characters on that team, starting with the head coach, Dan Campbell. The buy-in seems to be real, and after that slow start, a lot of close losses. But it looks like finally that hard work is paying off.
You know, they were at a tipping point, Chris, when they were sitting there at 1-6, because you look at Dan Campbell, and he's hard not to like. He wears his emotions on his sleeves. He's very, very high energy, and the players love him. But as a fan and as somebody following this team, you're watching them lose week after week, and then they went through a terrible stretch where they're getting clobbered. And you really wondered, would he survive this season? Would he be the next coach fired? But they've turned it around, and now the buy-in is 100%, not only with the players, but the fan base. And we're seeing he's not just a knuckle-dragger and a knee-breaker and a guy who can just go in and motivate some guys. He's got a staff around him that can really coach.
Yeah, so far he has not bitten any kneecaps off, nor has his team. But Jared Goff at quarterback, I mean, obviously a first-round pick, a lot thought of him, but traded from the Rams over to Detroit. He had some struggles. But as a fantasy owner, I can tell you his numbers have been terrific. What's been the change with him as far as a leader and his production on the field?
He's not turning it over. But the biggest thing is, I think the Lions have one of the best offensive lines in all of football. And whereas you went into last season with absolutely no receivers, except for maybe TJ Hawkinson, the emergence of Amon-Ra St. Brown and the backfield of Jamal Williams and DeAndre Swift, that tandem, they've got a lot of weapons now. And you're also seeing, you know, just last week, they got their first reception and touchdown from Jamison Williams, who they took, you know, they took him in the first round, traded up to get him. And he is a guy that on his first reception, he's got all this talent. It's going to take him a while to emerge. I think next year you'll really see him. But you add another piece in there, and suddenly Goff has a lot of pieces around him. He's playing his best football. The big question going into next year, Chris, is will they use one of those first-round picks? They've got the Rams' first-round pick from that Goff and Stafford trade, and they've got their own first-round pick. Right now the Rams' pick is like the number three pick in the draft. Do they take a quarterback, or do they stick with Goff? I still think they're going to go with a quarterback somewhere in the first round next year.
Yeah, it's a heavy quarterback draft when you think about at least in that top 5 or 10 picks. And finally for you, Jack, you've been up there. You know what a great sports community is. Are people buying in? Is there a buzz for the first time in a long time about this Lions team? Are they on board and excited about maybe not this year, but in the years to come?
I think suddenly they're excited about this year because – Chris, think about what Detroit fans have been through with the Tigers and the Red Wings and the Pistons and the Lions. Not just bad teams, but it's been a historically bad run where you're looking at first, second, third pick in all the drafts. It's just been a brutal, brutal stretch for Detroit fans. But this Lions team right now, having won 5 out of 6, people are really excited. And if you watch that game against the Vikings, that place was absolutely berserk. We're used to seeing fans walk around there. If you remember in the Matt Millen years, the Millen Man March, people with bags on their head demanding that the GM get fired. But right now, Detroit is bought in to this team. They love this coach. I don't think Dan Campbell's buying his own beer anywhere in the state of Michigan right now. People have really bought in. And it's kind of fun for a change to be excited about this product.
Well, Jack, always great to talk to you. Yes, some struggles for the pro teams, but you still got the Wolverines. We'll see how they do, but that's a story for another day, and we will talk to you down the road.
All right, Chris, see you.
A full slate of games this week starts on Thursday night. Division rivals and playoff contenders getting together in Seattle as the Seahawks host the 49ers. San Fran, a three-point road favorite in this one. With college football's regular season over, we get an NFL triple header on Saturday, starting with the Colts visiting Minnesota, the Vikings an impressive 6-1 on the home turf, and at 4:30, an AFC North showdown in Cleveland between the Ravens and Browns, Deshaun Watson still trying to get back to his all-pro form. And at 8:15, a huge game in the AFC East as the Dolphins hit the road to face the Bills on the Buffalo beat. Here's our Josh Reed.
Over the last seven games, Josh Allen has only thrown for over 300 yards one time. The passing game is really struggling right now. Drop passes are a big issue. And besides Stephon Diggs, the rest of the group has really underachieved. So GM Brandon Bean of the Bills took a swing on signing Cole Beasley. There he is at practice on Wednesday. Cole and Josh Allen had nice chemistry for three seasons. He's a player Josh could rely on to make a catch over the middle and get that tough first down.
I have played it for a long time. I got a good understanding for defenses and how they work, and I know how to manipulate defenders and create more space within whatever defense they're playing.
He knows when it's man, it's zone. We run different concepts with him because he can read basically two guys at one time, which not everybody can do. It's not the easiest thing. But definitely some concepts that maybe we'll bring back if he's back.
You know, there's no promises on either side where his snaps will go to when he's ready for a game, whether he's ready for a game this week, whether it's next week, whatever. It's just kind of, hey, come jump in the team, help us any way you can.
Beasley did not roll out playing this Saturday against the Dolphins. GM Brandon Bean says they have not closed the door on Odell Beckham Jr. and that signing Cole Beasley does not change anything. I'm Josh Reed.
On Sunday, six games in the 1 o'clock window, including two former co-workers on the Colts staff leading their teams in the battle in Chicago. Nick Sirianni's Eagles taking on Matt Eberflus's Bears. The Falcons in Atlanta to face the Saints. The Steelers visit the suddenly surging Panthers, and the Chiefs in Houston against the one-win Texans. In the 4 o'clock Eastern window, the Patriots on a short week continuing their playoff push. They're out in Vegas against the Raiders, and the Bengals will take their five-game win streak into Tampa to face the now below 500 Buccaneers. Tom Brady and company, however, still atop the NFC South despite a 6-7 record. At 4:25, Tennessee, losers of three straight, head out west to challenge the Chargers. For more on the reeling Titans, here's Corey Curtis in the Music City.
Well, they've lost three in a row and have given up 71 points over the last two games, but I think it's safe to say the Titans head coach Mike Vrabel isn't exactly lining up the animals two by two at this point. There's no question. The Tennessee Titans have got to get better, and that is the key. The Titans have been their own problem. They fixed the run game on Sunday only to turn it over four times. That is very un-Titan-like. They also have to start pressuring the quarterback again. Again, these are all things they control.
Well, the challenge is just getting back to eliminating bad football. You know, I mean, we have too many opportunities to do good things, and we have to eliminate bad football.
And we completely, you know, beat ourselves in that game. Having four turnovers is not gonna win you the game. So this game is about, you know, taking care of the football and then getting turnovers, and, you know, we didn't do that.
All right, four games to go. Here's how the Titans get to the playoffs. Any combination of two Titan wins or losses by the Colts eliminates Indianapolis. Now, their magic number with the Jaguars is any combination of three. There is still a possibility Titans and Jags could play for a spot in the playoffs the last game of the season. Now, up next for the Titans are the Los Angeles Chargers. They just knocked off the Dolphins on Sunday night and moved back into the AFC playoff picture.
On Sunday Night Football, a division contest of epic proportions with postseason implications. The Commanders and Giants play to a tie in Week 13. They're tied in the standings at 7-5-1, holding the last two playoff spots in the NFC, and they'll meet each other again this week. Here's Brandy Flores on the Commanders beat.
The Washington Commanders will be in the spotlight this Sunday night, taking on the New York Giants from FedEx Field. And this is a must-win game. The Commanders started the season 1-4 and have completely turned it around. And they are chomping at the bit for the opportunity to control their own destiny.
There's just something about the attention. I think we've got guys that seem to relish the opportunity of the moment.
It's a bunch of guys that have had to go through some stuff to get to the point where they're at, and I think we all kind of put that on our shoulders. We wear it in every battle, and that's just who we are.
Each week, we are closer to Chase Young's imminent return. Although he has been a full participant at practices, no announcement on if he will take the field this Sunday for the first time this season. But it's not like Chase hasn't thought about it.
Man, I've been envisioning it a lot. I've been envisioning getting a sack. I've been envisioning getting in the backfield. You got to envision it before you do it. So I've been envisioning everything.
The last time the Commanders played during primetime, they took down the previously undefeated Philadelphia Eagles on the road. Having the advantage to play their most important game of the season at home, the players expect FedEx Field to be packed on Sunday.
You better come out to FedEx Field, please. That's all you need to do. Come out to FedEx Field on Sunday night. That's it.
So the Commanders host the Giants this Sunday night, and if they don't win, their fate for a playoff push will be left up to chance.
On Monday Night Football, a game that probably looked really good on paper when the schedule came out, the Rams at Green Bay. But right now, the reigning Super Bowl champs are 4-9, the Packers just 5-8. But hey, let's see what Baker Mayfield can do for an encore after leading LA to a comeback win over the Raiders just last week. Well, that brings us to Peyton's picks, and we can't do that without our man in Chi-Town, the son of sweetness, Jared Peyton. A perfect 3-0 last week, now 30-11-1 on the season. JP, unheard of results. Can you keep the train rolling this week?
Chris, man, always great to talk to you. And yeah, I mean, anytime that you close your eyes and you're throwing darts at the board, find a way to go 3-0 some weeks, you know?
We got some magic darts. Let's pull them out right now and start throwing them. Let's go with the Lions at the Jets. Surprisingly, playoff implications now for both teams.
All right, crazy, right, to see what the Lions have been able to do. You saw last week what I did. I went with the Lions, especially because they're at home and how well they're playing at home. Jared Goff and company playing well. Dan Campbell having this team on a roll right now. But, man, this one's a little bit tough for me. I wanted to go with my heart. My heart says to go with the Lions, Chris, but my mind's telling me to go with the Jets. I think I'm doing that because defensively, I just think at home, they're going to be too tough. They find ways to get after the quarterback. They can sack the quarterback. And then also that back end of that defense is just too strong. I think they're going to rely on that defense to kind of hold the game in place. And then they'll find ways opportunity-wise on offense to be able to score some points. Mike White and company, they get the dub in New Jersey.
Two teams I have been rooting for all season. That should be a fun one. What about this one? Your old squad, the Titans, they got some problems. And they'll be out there taking on the Chargers on the West Coast.
All right, let's open it up right now and be honest. Yeah, my old squad is not doing well right now. And I mean, you look at the Chargers and what they're able to do, especially on the offensive side of the ball. Justin Herbert coming off of a big win against the Finns. I just think offensively how their run is being able to spread it out throughout the passing game. And Austin Eckler, he is that guy that's at wild card on offense. He finds a way either through the passing game or controlling the game on the ground. Justin Herbert's a little bit too hot right now. And that Titans defense is crumbling at the moment. They just lost to the Jags. So I'm going to side with the Chargers. The Bolts are going to win this one.
Now, perhaps the most dramatic and anger-filled and a lot on the line game on the entire board. Giants at Commanders, a lot going on between these two, and they just played a couple of weeks ago.
I know, right? And ended at a tie. So, I mean, this is what we're talking about, two teams. This game got flexed, so people are going to be watching this game. You look at the Giants, right? It comes down to why they've been having so many issues over the last few weeks. And you look at Saquon Barkley, who, you know, a couple of weeks ago, Chris, I was telling you that he was going to be the difference maker. He was early in the season. He hasn't been late in the season as well. They haven't been able to get the ground game going. Washington just finds a way. And I really want to side with the Commanders here because I think they're going to control the game with their offensive line and also with Brian Robinson and company in the backfield. They control the game on the ground. And one thing is for sure, Riverboat Ron, since he's been in Washington, 5-2 in primetime games. That has changed from back in those days when it comes to Washington teams. So I think Ron Rivera and the Commanders, they get the dub.
So Jared says there's no place like home. Let's review Peyton's picks. He'll take the Jets over the Lions. He likes the Chargers over the struggling Titans. And he'll go with his man, Riverboat Ron, the Commanders over the Giants. Now, JP, you better stay hot because I need that Christmas money. A lot riding on this week's picks.
Hey, man, always. You know I'm going to stay hot. And guess what? With that Christmas money, you can get me a birthday present, December 26th. I'll be waiting.
All right, let me write that down. JP, December 26th. Hey, my friend, always good to talk to you. Let's do it again next week.
See you, Chris.
And now it's time to take our weekly listen around the league. Players and coaches alike, let's hear what's being said into an open mic.
I lost a bunch of weight, and so it was a matter of kind of getting that back, but not, you know, with cheeseburgers, right? So
I'm excited to go out there and play football and be, you know, and get back in the old school uniforms and you know, the white face masks and things like that, and have a little bit of fun and just try to, you know, make the Saturday, you know, something special for Cleveland.
As competitors, there's absolutely still possibility. I mean, we had a, whatever, 5% chance last year, you know, whatever it was. And so crazier things have happened, you know, but none of that even matters unless we take care of today and win this week.
If it ain't broke, don't fix it. You know, every week we've been focusing on what is it going to take to win just one game, you know, and that's how you win six straight. You just take it one at a time, and this is another game that we got to find a way to win in a hostile environment against our biggest, you know, rival.
There's probably more pressure, I would say, because years past we knew that we were going to make the playoffs at least, worst case scenario. Now we have to win these next four and then let the rest do itself for us to be able to make it in there.
You can't ride the roller coaster forever, right? But we got to start going back up. So the team we want to be is the team to beat Cincy, and then we'll take it from there. I think when you start looking at things from years past or looking at the length of the season or what's in front of us or the division and all that stuff, you get away from what's important.
My entire life, I don't remember. I mean, he was drafted when I was four, so all my memories of NFL football have him in it. You know, I think he epitomizes toughness at the quarterback position. You know, he's a great leader. He's the greatest of all time for a reason.
And on that note, let's call it a show. For Jared Payton, producer Phil Nardiello, and our correspondents across the entire NextStar Nation, I'm Chris Hagan. Thanks for watching. Good luck in your fantasy playoffs, and we'll see you next time on Big Game Bound.